Gildan Media presents Your Coach in a Box, affordable, life-changing audio programs.
Heartfelt Marketing, allowing the universe to be your business partner. Read by me, Jacquie Jordan. To Richard Wehner, every woman deserves a champion. Thank you for being mine. Acknowledgements. I have been privileged to work with many gifted people. New folks are always showing up every day and offering me new and exciting perspectives on my life and my business. Then there are those who I've been working with over time and who were directly involved in the making of this book. I am in deep gratitude for their generosity and wisdom. Here is a partial list of them and some of their contributions. Chris McLean, for holding the vision for the workshop and its content back when it was called Spiritual Marketing, before it was thought that this name could be a religious statement. Amy Superfood Fairy and Patrick Smith for the faith. Sharon and Jeff for the practice of heartfelt friendship. Doris Fisher for being absolutely solid. Doris, remember that night when we said, why can't we find the 20-year-old version of ourself? Stephanie Cobian for being the best assistant ever. Starla and Chris for always making me look good. The cover captures the essence. Jordan for the patience and talent you showed in bringing out my concept for the cover. Jonathan for taking Chris's idea and yours and merging the two to create the concept that, in spite of day-to-day insanity and chaos, we can still live from our hearts. All the guestsperts, the most amazing messengers of heartfelt messages. The Berman Books gang, Sanjay Berman and John Manikaros, for their faithful support. Barbara Aronica for her patience with the endless back and forth of changes and details. For the ghost team, Mark Parsons, Stephen Horniak, and Lainey Adamson and team for editing the first draft manuscript. Introduction. The intention of this book is to share with you my definition of success and, based on that definition, share ways of applying it to your business and making a contribution to others. You may or may not agree with me. The best possible scenario is that you will develop your own definition of success and not allow others to do that for you. I've had a lot of professional, quote, success, unquote, during my time as a television producer, Emmy nominations, money, prestige, and elbow rubbing with the rich and famous. My definition of success is quite different today. I suspect, given the recent changes in the global economy, that I am not alone. What you might expect me to write next is the following cliché. I have less money and fewer things now, but I am successful because I am far happier than I was when I had all that stuff. That actually is not my truth either, as that does not define my version of success. We must define our own version of success. However, it is important for us to anchor ourselves in our own reality and our own purpose and to take care of ourselves, our responsibilities, and our obligations fully to the best of our ability on a daily basis. One, so that we are not drawn into the big fear, the tornado, or quicksand of drama. And two, that we can bring forward what we have here, which is our experience, strength, and hope, and we do that through the assets of our goals and our service to others. My hope with you on the journey with me through this book is to sync up your internal beliefs about who you are, what you are trying to create, why you are trying to do it, and how you can be of service through the expression of your vocation or your business through the busyness of daily living. I come from working in the talk television industry, a highly pressured and competitive arena. Out of my television career grew the media development business that I own today, where I can offer my professional input and experience by helping others with their own career trajectories. I've experienced success, and I've also experienced the ground beneath my feet suddenly shifting and dropping away. That's a scary place to be. But I learned many valuable lessons along the way, and that's why I wrote Heartfelt Marketing, to share my experience and show you how to thrive, survive, prosper, and enjoy life in the professional marketplace, coming from your heart, not your head. Author's note. I had the opportunity to publish my book this month. I was behind. I wanted it to be between 40,000 and 60,000 words, but I was at 20,000 words. It was supposed to be a hardcover book, and it was becoming a softcover. Three of my big-name celebrity endorsements had backed out, for one polite reason or another. My clients' projects always seemed to take precedence over my own deadlines and deliverables. The direction of what I was teaching in workshops was not coming out on paper. In fact, I felt like I was writing an entirely different book. 6 weeks ago, I got a gentle call from the publisher. "Jacquie, how's the book coming?" In my head, I answered, "It's not." Out of my mouth came, "It's good. Can't wait for you to have it." Panic, panic, panic. Perfectionism, perfectionism, perfectionism. I wanted to call him back and renegotiate. "Can we deliver in the next quarter?" But the truth always is, if not now, when? Were my circumstances, responsibilities, workload, commitments going to change? Was a bestseller going to come out of me in 3 more months? Should I really be needing the bread any longer? And this is how the dance goes. I then realized that my clients have been my greatest teachers. I have witnessed over and over again the presentation of opportunity and the reaction of many folks, not all, as they push back on the door they so wanted opened. I realized that getting this book completed was simply not going to be comfortable. I quickly accepted the realization that it might not be more than 20,000 words, reducing the size from the outline's projection of 225 pages to 90 pages. I also realized that this book might not be my bestseller after all. What I did own in the moment was that I was and am not going to desert myself and bow to perfectionism, that it doesn't have to be perfect, that this may be my second book of 32 books. How was I to know? The bottom line is show up, which means that I risk being judged, criticized, not famous, not wealthy because of this book. It also means that I am standing by this book as an offering. I am saying, this is who I am, this is what I have learned. I choose to risk coming from the heart, not from the head, to share with you what I know. So please accept my humble writings as I put into motion what I am practicing, which is living and doing business from a place of authenticity. Taking the risk of putting myself out there is the essence of heartfelt marketing because I believe I have something to offer that would be of service. Chapter 1, The World Out of Balance. Collectively, we're in pretty tough shape. It is clear that the way the world has been run is not self-supporting. We're overdrawn, we're overextended, what used to work no longer works. In mass, we are experiencing a kind of collective spiritual bankruptcy. But those of us reading this book don't need to be part of that treacherous collective. We don't need to get swept up in other people's terrors or breakdowns, and we don't need to go down with the ship. Just because you or someone you know is having an external breakdown, that's not necessarily a bad thing. Oftentimes, a breakdown leads to a breakthrough. Outside the intense discomfort of the unknown and the projection of catastrophic worst-case scenarios, the breakdowns actually create space or room for new creative life growth and solutions to enter. Sometimes we have to let go of the old to make room for the new. Before we explore those solutions in heartfelt marketing, let's take off the gloves and get honest about how we got where we are. We are out of balance due to spiritual and material bankruptcy. When I use the term spiritual bankruptcy or bankruptcy of the heart, I mean a state of imbalance in which we are not connected to our hearts or our souls. In this state, we focus on the material and we lose sight of who we are and why we are here. Its opposite kissing cousin is a material bankruptcy, in which we lose our homes, businesses, credit ratings, when all seems lost. The two states of mind are polar opposites, yet they feed off each other and make us fearful. Fear feeds fear in a vicious cycle. It is a trap, but a trap from which we can escape. Spiritual bankruptcy comes when we value material things more than our hearts, either consciously or unconsciously. Either way, we are alienated from the best we have to offer. In this state, we are also alienated from the talents and skills that we can use to become satisfied, rightfully rewarded contributors to society. These talents and skills are our gifts. Each one of us can use them to leave our life's thumbprint. When we have money fear, career malaise, or financial panic, we start to lose ourselves and our focus becomes solely material. When the material aspects of life are all that we can see and all that we can think about, we slip into a downward spiral. But we can step off of this downward spiral. This book is about getting into a state of complementary harmony between our interior state of being, heart and spirit, and our exterior state of being, our careers and businesses, or day-to-day busynesses. And achieving that balance is all about listening to stories and advice, like the material in this book, and applying them to our lives. You can start this process now. In fact, you already have, by reading these words. And while learning how to balance takes some time, once we have it, it becomes second nature. When we learn to ride a bike, we wobble and fall and skin our knees. But once we master the skill, we never forget it. We ride on confidently and get where we are going. The balance, the integration, the complementary harmony that each of us is looking for is the ability to make a living by following our heart's desire. It's simple, but it's not easy. Otherwise, most folks would be able to answer in the affirmative if we asked them if they are living their dreams. When we are living our dreams, and by the act of living our dreams, we are fully self-supporting. We are in spiritual and material integration. Chapter 2, The Beginning of Balance, Releasing and Allowing. Releasing, releasing, releasing. Allowing, allowing, allowing. Remember the old real estate adage, location, location, location? Here in Heartfelt Marketing, allowing and its sibling, releasing, will be the basic tools in your kit. You will learn to release blocks that are getting in the way of business expansion, release energetic tackiness that screams inferiority in your business exchanges, release the 5 pitfalls that spell doom to revenue generation, allow yourself to see that intention and language make a huge difference in the sale, allow yourself to get out of your own way and generate business by being of service to others. Every village has a marketplace. It is said it takes a village to raise a child. We are all in this together, raising children, uplifting and supporting one another, earning our daily bread and sharing common life worries, sorrows, and more importantly, joys. From the humblest worker to the highest poobah of success, we all have much the same needs, dreams, and ambitions. And we all have hard nights when sleep does not come and doubts about our careers and our futures arise. That's all part of the life curriculum of being a human being living on.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.